This is a regular pentagon, which is a great shape. The diagonal, if you go from corner to corner like that, is the golden ratio times the unit edge. And don't get me wrong, I love other shapes that do similar things. A square, square's pretty exciting. It's got a diagonal equal to the square root of 2, another wonderful constant. However, if you take a square and you go up a dimension and make a cube, the space diagonal, diagonals in space, is root 3 times the unit edge. I'm like, oh my goodness, so a square to a cube goes from root 2 to root 3. If we start with a pentagon and we go up, we go from the golden ratio to what? Well, I want to find out, which is why I haven't just got one of these. I've actually got 12. They're made from laser cut clear acrylic. Once I peel off all of these bits of film, we're going to build a regular pentagonal dodecahedron, and we're going to see how long its space diagonals are. Quick AOB, I will be doing an evening of Unnecessary Detail on Sunday the 14th of April in New York City. Me, Grant Sanderson, other amazing guests, and pre-orders for Love Triangle are available worldwide. All the links and details, if you want a signed first edition with a limited book cover, in the description below.
Oh, this is going to take forever. Alex, do you want to give me a hand with this? You can do.
Sure.
Those are for you. This is going to end up real big. Question is, do I tighten it now or do I build the... I think that's one large, transparent, regular, pentagonal dodecahedron. I just need to cut off all the stubble. There it is. 30 edges, each with 4 cable ties. 120 cable ties later, we have a regular pentagonal dodecahedron. Let's have a look at the diagonals. Unlike a cube, we have a choice of space diagonals. Diagonals in space! There are the longest ones. If you go from this vertex to the opposite one over there, that's the longest possible space diagonal. There are 20 vertices, so you pair them up. There are 10 of these that go right across the center. There are then like your mid, your medium size space diagonals. Instead of going straight across, you go to that one over there, which is ever so slightly closer. And then you got the smallest internal space diagonal, which is if you go from here to here. And we'll start with that one first. That is the shortest space diagonal. And just a quick recap, don't forget, it's all about the golden ratio. That's the golden ratio across the face from there to there. The distance from there to there is the golden ratio times root 2, that which is a square number. Well, not a square number, it's the number you get from a square. So actually, if that's root 2, then this is the length of a diagonal from a square made out of the face diagonals. You know, I'll mark them on. Here we go. One there, that corner. There. All right, so I've labeled 4 of the face diagonals, not the space diagonals, the face ones, and those 4 there, you can see, make a perfect square. So there is a square hidden inside a regular dodecahedron, which is why this space diagonal from there to diagonals in space to there is root 2 times the golden ratio, because that's the golden ratio, and that's a square. Amazing. Our next space diagonal, instead of just going from here across to this one, we're gonna go all the way over here. And that distance is the golden ratio times the golden ratio. Oh, thank goodness, we're back in Pentagon Town. So that actually means from there to there must be part of a pentagon. And we can see that if I label, I've got a long bit of green tape here. I'm going to mark in, I'm going to reuse that line, and I'm going to put in what I'm going to call the equator of the dodecahedron. So it's all the way around these sides like this, and then that should just line up there. There we go. And the equator, which is not quite half, but you get the idea, that is a perfectly regular pentagon. And these
face diagonals are each the golden ratio. So that you can see there. So it starts here, goes down there to there, and then down these sides to here, and then joins up. That is a regular pentagon with side length. Instead of being a unit side length like the faces, that's the golden ratio side length. So from there to there, which is the diagonal within the pentagon, is the golden ratio of a golden ratio pentagon. So that's why there we have the golden ratio squared. Lovely. But don't get too complacent, because our final space diagonal, the longest one in a regular dodecahedron, which goes all the way from one corner like the vertex up here to the most distant one like over here, that is the golden ratio times root 3. It's the cube. It's the cube ratio. So somehow there to there combines the pentagon ratio of the golden ratio with the cube ratio. Okay, I'm gonna label in some more edges, try and turn this square into a cube. All right, if I put in this last one here, from there to there, I'll wave this around in a second so you can see it clearly. I've now labeled 12 of these face diagonals, all on the surface of one of the faces of the dodecahedron, and they form a perfect cube. So there is a cube embedded in the surface of a regular pentagonal dodecahedron. And that cube goes from, so this corner down here, this vertex, to the opposite vertex of the cube is also one vertex of the dodecahedron to the opposite vertex of the dodecahedron. So that's why when you got this cube where all the edges are the golden ratio length, that the space diagonal of the dodecahedron is the same as the space diagonal of the cube, and the cube is golden ratio, which is why the big space diagonal in a dodecahedron is root 3 times the golden ratio. It's so nice. And this bright tape I've used to mark out the cube is not just bright in terms of color, it also fluoresces. So we're going to put this under a UV black light so you can see the dodecahedron turn into the cube. Yeah, I should have taped the inside as well.
But I couldn't be bothered.
One cube is fine, but the question now is how many cubes can we fit inside our dodecahedron? Well, each of these pentagon faces has, well, five of these face diagonals, and there's 12 of them, and 12 times 5 is 60. So we've actually got 60 of these we could use up to make cubes, and we've only used, well, 12, the 12 that give us a cube. You know, how many times does 12 go into 60? Well, it's 5. Turns out 5 times 12 is the same number as 12 times 5. Write that down in your workbooks now. So actually, because there are 5 diagonals per each of the 12 faces, we can get 5 cubes that each have 12 edges. We just gotta be very careful and line them up. And I'm gonna stop that from spinning. That's a bit too much. There we go. Now, if this seems at all familiar, you may have watched a video I made with Adam Savage over on their Tested channel. We built shapes using the space diagonals inside a dodecahedron. Have we built the shape first and then put the dodecahedron around the outside? Whereas what I've done here is the opposite, and the shape we were trying to make was the compound 5 intersecting tetrahedra, not cubes, triangle based pyramids. Here's a picture of what that looks like. I just went and took the standard picture of Wikipedia made in Stellar 3D. I've actually got a little printout of it here, and there you are. So that is one of the regular compound polyhedrons, and when Adam and I were building these, they've actually got mirror symmetry. So while Adam was building one based off the model that was directly in front of him, I was looking at it in a mirror, which was such a dumb idea. Seemed clever at the start, I regretted it immediately, so I could build the other chirality version of the shape. And the great thing about putting
five tetrahedra inside the dodecahedron is this has got, if you count them all up, there are 20 corners. And each one of the tetrahedra has four corners, and four times five is 20. So that every single corner, every vertex, matches one vertex on one of the tetrahedra. And what I mentioned in the video with Adam, and hello to everyone who came here from that video. If you haven't seen it, you don't have to watch it straight away. Everything should make sense in this video anyway, but definitely watch it afterwards. It was a huge amount of fun. I then mentioned you could combine both handednesses of the two different compound five tetrahedra and get this one, 10 intersecting tetrahedra. It's just that one combined with its mirror image, and now you've got two tetrahedra per vertex of the dodecahedron. So I'm going to put that one up on the board as well. So we're now up to two regular compound polyhedrons, and what we're building now is a third one. If I arrange all five cubes in here according to these diagonals nice and carefully, it will be perfectly regular. Just like the dodecahedron itself is a platonic solid, we can make the compound polyhedron version of a platonic solid, because the way they're arranged means every vertex is still indistinguishable. It's so nice. And if you did come from Adam's video, this is what I promised I would do on my channel. So I'm going to do it. I'm going to tape on the other four cubes, and we'll have another little UV polyhedron rave. Alright, isn't that absolutely incredible? So we've got all 60 face diagonals are now labeled in five different colors, 12 each, and that gives us our five intersecting cubes, which is a compound regular polyhedron. I might put a handful of lights back on again. Isn't it amazing that if you take three of these face diagonals from any one corner, they are all at right angles with each other. Those right angles are hidden inside the dodecahedron. And this is our next one of the regular compound polyhedra. So we can add five intersecting cubes to our collection up there. So good. It looks like, because it's every single pentagram, like the most flamboyant Satanist party you'll ever get to go to. And now, the obvious question that's left is how many are there? If there are five platonic solids, that is just five regular polyhedrons, how many regular compound polyhedrons are there? Also five. The other two that we haven't gone near is because one's complicated, one's boring. We've also got the two intersecting tetrahedra, Yawnsville, and we've got five intersecting octahedrons, which doesn't even have a convex hull. So I refuse to build either of those now, but I will put them up on the list. I mean, an obvious question is it significant that there are five regular polyhedrons and there are five compound ones? And I don't think so. I think it's just a coincidence that there are five of these. But what's very pleasing is three of them are all hidden inside a regular dodecahedron. So I've only got the edges as like a frame cube of each one, and the picture I nicked off Wikipedia has all the faces colored in as well. Same shape. So you can see the one I've done here, and you can go check out the left and right-handed five intersecting tetrahedra on Adam Savage's channel, which combined give us a 10. Thank you so much for watching. Do check out the video I did with Adam Savage over on the Tested channel. It was a huge amount of fun to make. And people who came here from Tested, thanks for coming along. You may know me from Numberphile and that video where I talk about spreadsheets. So this is my channel. Lots of ridiculous math things. Please do subscribe. I know it won't make a big difference to your viewing experience, because the algorithm knows what you're watching. It'll keep feeding you my videos now. Good luck avoiding me for a while, but if you do want to help support the channel and help me catch Steve Mould's subscriber number, I would hugely appreciate it if everyone watching could just take the time to go and unsubscribe from Steve Mould. Diagonals in space!